Welcome you all to this morning assembly on behalf of the entire Women Wordsmiths group. Today is the 24th of December and a Gujarati calendar pramane aje Maksar Vad Pacham Che. Prayer is one of the most important aspects in our life without which we and our lives are incomplete. So let us all begin our day by surrendering ourselves to the Almighty.
Der lagegi, magar sahi hoga. हमें जो चाहिए वही होगा क्योंकि दिन बुरे हैं मगर वो ऊपर वाला नहीं इसीलिए रखो भरोसा ईश्वर पर तुम करो उन पर ही विश्वास जब भी होगे तुम हताश नहीं करेंगे वो निराश आइए सुनते हैं एक तू ही भरोसा
हो जाओ किस से दुआ मांगे जीवन में सुकून चाहे चाहत में वफा मांगे हालात बदलने में अब दे
Awaited and joyful times of the year. Our today's theme will be Christmas. And firstly, to begin with our assembly, I would like to invite Ruhi for an English recitation called Heart of the Christmas.
Heart of Christmas.
Christmas time is here. Happiness and cheer. The most awaited moment and the favorite time of the year. Children were filled with gladness and joy to unwrap those gifts and receive those holiday toys. And the young ones, the youth, those teenage girls and boys, were so excited and quickened to go to malls to buy those trend watch, good shirts, tighter jeans, and nice shoes. Girls still have a party in school. The adults, I'm talking to parents whose wish and desire to keep their family together on this united season, who are willing to do everything together and make some priceless memories on one table. And I really do hope and pray, even for this 100 days left before the Christmas season, that we must not forget the true essence, the true meaning, the true reason why we celebrate this season. That how God shows His great love, that He gave His one and only begotten Son, 2,000 years ago, and was born on a manger. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who came down to this earth and became the lowest man, not to be served, but to serve His people, who died for you on the cross, saved you and washed away your sins, and set you free from condemnation, who gave us eternal life, and that free gift of salvation in our true home to walk on streets of gold in heaven. Christmas is not always about Santa Claus, who can give you a gift. It is about the greatest gift that the whole earth and the whole mankind received. It's Jesus Christ. Jesus is the heart of Christmas.
Is a time of the year when we look forward to sharing love with our family and friends. We must practice gratitude and get along with a new hope. I would now like to invite Deva and Maitri Davda to recite the poem, At Christmas.
At Christmas by Edgar Albert Guest. A man is at his finest towards the finish of the year. A man is at his finest towards the finish of the year. He's almost what he should be when the Christmas season is here, when he's thinking more of others than he's thought the months before. And the laughter of his children is a joy worth toiling for. He's less a selfish creature than at any other time when the Christmas spirit rules him. He comes closer to the sublime. When it's Christmas, man is bigger and is better in his part. He's keener for the service that is prompted by the heart. All the petty thoughts and narrow seem to vanish for a while. and the true reward he's seeking is the glory of his smile. Then for others he's toiling. And somehow it seems to me that at Christmas he's almost what God wanted him to be.
If I had to paint a picture of a man, I think I would wait. If I had to paint a picture of a man, I think I would wait till he had fought his selfish battles and had put aside his hate. I would not catch him at his labors when his thoughts are all of self. On the long days and dreary when he's striving for himself, I would not take him when he's snaring, when he's scornful or depressed, but I would look for him at Christmas when he's shining at his best. Man is ever in a struggle. Man is ever in a struggle, and he's oft misunderstood. There are days the worst that's in him is the master of good. But at Christmas, kindness rules him. And he puts himself aside. And his petty hates are vanquished, and his heart is opened wide. Oh, I don't know how to say it, but somehow it seems to me that at Christmas, man is almost what God sent him here to be. Oh, I don't know how to say it, but somehow it seems to me that at Christmas, man is almost what God sent him here to be.
We have many characters, especially for Christmas, like Grinch. We all love to watch them with our family and friends, don't we? With this, I would like to invite Aheed and Himania for an English poem called The Gift.
A teenage girl had her plans reconstructed, her life interrupted when she was entrusted with something beyond our human measure, a treasure that was temporarily buried within her. Society would have classed her a sinner, but God's purpose for people was immaculate and bigger. This gold was something the Grinch could never steal. There wasn't lights on trees and the smell of chestnuts in the breeze. The night before Christmas was revealed more like a journey of over 70 miles in a race against time. Not an elf in a film. The father lay all of his cards on the table for the hope of the new world to be born on the floor of a stable. Regardless of the circumstances surrounding, all who were around him bowed, and in their hearts they crowned him. His name, Jesus, crowned the Prince of Shalom, absolute and completeness. He's unchanging and unmovable. The child was a given, as he was the only one suitable. A bright star shone a light on stage, framing the opening scene of this reality play, where a child was given the responsibility of the world, regardless of his age. The angels shouted glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward man. Their praise was relayed on the lips of the shepherds as they journeyed toward the stable, as the Bible says, with haste, and dropped on their knees in the hay and let their worship display, while the animals around could only do the same. Wise men from the east traveled far from where they were to honor the king with gold, frankincense, and myrrh. That day, an innocent lion was born.
And the world adored. What is a worthy gift I can leave before him? A gift that is worthy for the king of all kings, like placing your presents on Christmas Eve under the family Christmas tree. Without Jesus, what would Christmas be? He destroys yokes and moves burden. He's a provider, healer, and a hope. Then certain with grace without bounds, and love without conditions. Freedom in his hands to free the captives from their presents, like placing their presents on Christmas Eve under the family Christmas tree. Without Jesus, what would Christmas be? An honor for the King, we will worship at His feet. Thank you.
Christmas is the spirit of giving without a thought of getting. It is happiness because we find joy in other people. It is forgetting self and finding time for others. It is discarding the meaningless and stressing the true values. With this, I would like to invite Dhruvi Dilwa and Raja Davra to recite a poem, The Whole Piece.
It's back like it never left. It's that time of year again. I mean, it was hardly New Year's Eve. Hard to believe that time is here again. Supposed to be a snowfall, but this is where the perfect storm begins. I used to look forward to it all. Now I can't wait for it all to end. You don't understand. I have got to find and pick all the right gifts, making sure no one's missed on my never-ending list. I've got Amazon, but it's not Prime, so it won't come online, forcing me to the store like it's 2004, just to wait and line. It's all lights on the tree and lights on the house, and all the Hobby Lobby decorations she couldn't live without. It's candy canes and ugly sweaters, parties to host and get-togethers. It's centerpieces, gift wrapping, gift cards, and the list goes on forever.
Can't sleep because of the stress. If you're asking why I'm nervous, well, you won't get it, but I'll tell you. You see, it all has to be perfect. I've got to get it just right to capture all the hearts and likes and thumbed up hands. How else will I know if I've piqued the Pinterest of all my judges on Instagram? But what I don't understand is how my season of chaos could also be known as the season of peace. They say it's everywhere, it's all around us, but yet somehow it's still elusive to me. It's almost like every other card and every other song just serves as a reminder. They all say it's peace on earth, but that seems to be the last place where I can find it. But a part of me believes this isn't what you intended or invented, because you crowned your son the Prince of Peace, and that's why you sent him peace, not just for one day or 365. A peace which would last for our entire lives.
But that's too much for us to grasp, so we avoid it like it's danger. Cause we are more comfortable with baby Jesus, so we keep him in the manger. But if we keep him as a baby, we lose part of the story. When we confine him to a crib, we rob him of his glory. He'll never grow up until we come to a tree and realize the star hanging from the top is there to rescue you and me. The sand, the sides are for and against, and we clearly see where we stand. When we choose our own way, we choose to turn against you. When we chose to turn away, your enemy is what we turn into.
But when your blood was spilled, peace settled the score, and when the stone was rolled, peace ended the war. The Prince of Peace became a treaty whose designed to restore all the closeness in the garden we enjoyed like before. For so long we've been locked out, but peace unlocked the door and brought back everything we lost and gave us so much more. That's peace I'm holding on to. I can't grasp with understanding. It's the only peace of its kind to transform death into dancing. This peace keeps my heart like Mary in the midst of my Martha planning. It calms and quiets my soul in this season that's so demanding. So, it's the cradle and the cross, your peace helps me accept and believe it. So when you say peace be unto you, every piece of me receives it. So when you say peace be unto you, every piece of me receives it.
Nationality is the creative power of human culture, and culture is the creative power of nationality. So let's all rise for the national anthem. Assembly Savdhan.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind, Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. ಪಂಜಾಬ್ ಸಿಂಧ್ ಗುಜರಾತ್ ಮರಾಠ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ ಉತ್ಕಳ ಬಂಗಾ ವಿಂಧ್ಯ ಹಿಮಾಚಲ ಯಮುನಾ ಗಂಗಾ ಉಚ್ಚಲ ಜಲಧಿ ತರಂಗಾ ತವ ಶುಭ ನಾಮೇ ಜಾಗೇ ತವ ಶುಭ ಆಶಿಷ ಮಾಗೇ ಗಾಹೇ ತವ ಜಯ ಗಾಥಾ ಜನಗಣ ಮಂಗಳದಾಯಕ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಭಾರತ ಭಾಗ್ಯ ವಿಧಾತಾ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ 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 ಹೇ
Assembly Vishram. I would now like to invite Abhi Dilwa to share the point to Socho.
Christmas is the festival which marks the birth of Jesus Christ. On Christmas, everyone dresses in red clothes and sings carols and even decorate their houses with Christmas trees. Children too are very excited for Christmas as they get lots of gifts from Santa Claus. And that's where our today's question arises. Do you believe in Santa's existence? In the air, he comes with his sleigh with a bag full of gifts, a man who enlightens all with happiness. Santa Claus has been a remarkable feature of Christmas. He is believed as the Dutch version of Saint Nicholas. In England, he became the father of Christmas, and in Austria and Germany, he became a helper and began to be the bringer of gifts. He made gifts by himself and gave to poor kids who could use it. He was considered as a man of kindness who dressed in American fur. He portrayed himself not as a priest but as a jolly dimple elf with twinkle in his eye. He was portrayed by a grandfather-like person in red suit by many cartoonists. It was believed that he must be like a little elf. The poem named Night Before Christmas describes Santa drove a sleigh pulled by 8 reindeers which landed on a roof. In today's popular world, many people dress like Santa and spread happiness within the kids. We don't know about the existence of Santa, but always hope for a person like him. Do you believe in Santa? Zara socho.
We hope you enjoyed our assembly. Have an amazing day ahead. I would like to call the music team for the exit song.
When Christ was born, on Christmas Day, when Christ was born on Christmas Day, oh how I want to be in that number. When Christ was born on Christmas Day, oh when we hear
when Christ was born.